How's everybody doing? All right, we're moving along here. I'd just like to say it's an honor to share the stage with such talented, accomplished people. And I feel like every winner, all the people who've come up here, you guys have such a humility. You do such great work, and it's very refreshing. And I feel honored to be part of your evening. So thank you. So I wanted to just run a couple of ideas. I know there are a lot of very gifted people in this audience. I have a couple ideas. Take them or leave them. Recently, I had an idea. I have a couple of little kids that I'm related to. They're my children. And I noticed my daughter screaming in a very, very annoying way in the car. But also, I realized in the right context, it could be a great voice that she has there. She's a year and a half, so it's a little early. But could somebody develop an app that you hold maybe up your phone to your screaming child? It figures out what key the baby is crying in and then selects a song so the baby's basically singing lead or at least accompanying. Maybe? I don't know, because she was doing pretty well if I had the right backing for that. I don't have the technology to. My earlier invention, before I had kids, it was for when you're on an airplane and there's a baby crying and it's just bothering everybody. And one time I was on a plane, I was like, how could you get that baby quiet? And then it hit me. It's called the baby silencer. So the idea is it's a funnel that goes over the baby's nose and mouth with a tube that goes to headphones to the baby's own ears, you see. So as the baby's screaming, it's like, wah, wah, ow, that hurts. Wait, hello? That's me. I should stop. You see, so you're teaching the baby. I think it's humane. You know, I haven't done research, but I'm pretty sure the baby would learn pretty quickly that it's hurting itself more than everybody else. And it's a teaching moment, really. So this is called the baby silencer. Again, no patent pending, whatever. If anybody wants to talk after the show, I'm sure you guys could do something better with buttons or some sort of console to really fuck with the baby's head. It's like, oh, I'm a monster now or something. I don't know. Micro-Korg. I love my micro-Korg. I could see Korg technology into that, for certainly. We're not hurting the baby, though. Let's remember. So the other thing I just wanted to share really quickly is maybe something that we could impart to younger people. If you're learning how to read music when you're younger, you know, they teach you about the clef here, and there's mnemonic devices. Maybe you know that every good boy does fine. Did I hold it up like that? Yeah. Or every good boy deserves fudge, I've heard. Those are memorable. I mean, I certainly remember them. I think we can do better, though, if we're going to teach kids, you know. Elephants go bald daily. Fuck. Eating gas, bad diarrhea farts. That's good for kids. Yeah. Entire generation blows. Damn it, Facebook. Yeah, come on. The last one is just tell the kid to spell egg, but don't finish. E-G, but don't finish. All right. Very heady stuff here. Okay. Congratulations again to the section. They'll be back in a little while for a very special performance, which is going to be awesome. So that's great. All right. So let's move along here. Yeah, there we go. Sorry. That was not my fault. Fucking tech, unbelievable. I'm just kidding. Our next presenters are from two different parts of the music world, but both are remarkably skilled at what they do. He is a 5-time Grammy Award-winning producer, engineer, and mixer who, according to Wikipedia, has truly mastered the art of dynamic range compression in both hardware and software. Of course. Maybe he'll give me... maybe I can get a set of signature plugins. I don't know. Based on how I'm reading the prompter, I don't think I'm going to be getting anything. With him, we also have a musician who 10 years ago, because of her talent and her age, was voted the year's most exciting new player in Bass Player magazine. That's an honor she earned back when she was jamming with the Allman Brothers and touring with Jeff Beck and Chick Corea and working with Prince and Herbie Hancock when the only word to describe her was prodigy. Was that? Did I fuck up? All right, sorry. All right. Good night, everybody. That's it. I was just kidding. Now with a thriving recording career and a recent opening act stint singing her songs on tour with The Who, we can just call her an amazing artist. Please welcome Chris Lord-Alge and Tal Wilkenfeld.
Tech Awards, here we are.
Woo!
Wake up, because it's party time, because CLA and Tal have entered the building. Wow.
Thank you, Demetri, back there. I'm proud to be here tonight to honor the people who make the equipment that do make what I do possible. By the way, do any of you guys make a hair straightener? Because I'm sick of getting mistaken for Robert Plant.
Well, he doesn't play bass, does he? You played with Prince, huh? That kicks ass. You went on tour with The Who? That's totally awesome. I want to do that. During the year, we think of the brand names we work with, but tonight we get to honor the remarkably talented individuals to whom we so indebtedly for actually making the badass stuff.
So the first award we're presenting is for excellence in film sound production. Here are the nominees.
Dunkirk. Guardians of the Galaxy, Volume 2.
Rocket! Got it! Jack up our prices if we're two-time Galaxy Savers.
Hacksaw Ridge.
Let's go!
We got company!
Come on!
La La Land. Rogue One, A Star Wars Story.
And the winner for Best Film Sound Production goes to Rogue One, A Star Wars Story.
Come on down.
Hi there. I didn't actually work on Star Wars, so Pete Cobbin, who is the mixing engineer, is a friend of mine. I manufacture equipment with Abbey Road under contract, and I work with him extensively with Abbey Road products. So he asked me to come in. He's in session in London. But Pete's a very creative, he's detailed, but very creative person. He's done a number of amazing things, Lord of the Rings. He remixed the entire John Lennon catalog for Yoko. And I really look up to him. I've been working with him for about 15 years. Sorry, I'm nervous. but anyway, I know he really appreciates this. He's just busy working, so thank you very much.